Good evening. This is W. H. Pugmire, and I'm here to discuss the Cthulhu mythos and touch upon the nature of Lovecraftian pastiche. What makes a story a pastiche of H.P. Lovecraft? Now, I've been thinking about this because for probably the past 2 decades, I have been trying to convince myself that I do not write pastiche of Lovecraft. When I think of pastiche, I think of writing in the voice of Lovecraft, in the narrative voice of Lovecraft. But I think that is not a complete idea of what pastiche is composed of. When we speak of Lovecraftian pastiche or of pastiche of the Cthulhu mythos, I think it must also contain story ideas. A pastiche of Lovecraft's mythos would not only echo the Rococo prose style, narrative style of Lovecraft's fiction, but it would contain either his original Great Old Ones and his Necronomicon type books, the Book of Ibon, Mysteries of the Worm, and also his towns and cities such as Kingsport, Innsmouth, Dunwich, Arkham. I have written many tales set in Kingsport. But not all of those tales, and perhaps not any of those stories, could actually be termed tales of the Cthulhu mythos. I've been thinking about this because I spent last weekend in Portland, Oregon, at the H. P. Lovecraft Film Festival and Cthulhu Con. It was just called the Lovecraft Film Festival, but my friends and I have been working these past few years to bring more and more mythos writers to this thing. And we have been quite successful. This year, we were extremely lucky to have Michael Shea. Michael Shea will have a new collection of mythos fiction published by Perilous Press, probably this year. He was there. Joe Pulver was there. Joe, of course, wrote Nightmare's Disciple, a mythos novel for Chaosium. Robert M. Price was there. Robert, of course, as most of you probably will know, edited the Call of Cthulhu fiction books, the cycle books for Chaosium, the Dunwich cycle, the Innsmouth cycle, the Azathoth cycle, the Shub-Niggurath cycle, etc., the Nyarlathotep cycle, which is perhaps my favorite in that series. And he will have a new book published by Hippocampus entitled The Tyndallus Cycle, should be published this year. Stories by the Cthulhu mythos fiction of Frank Belknap Long, and stories inspired by the mythos fiction of Frank Belknap Long. So Bob Price is there. He's delightful. We also had, for the first time, Gary Myers. Gary Myers wrote a mythos novel, a mythos collection called The House of the Worm, which was published by Arkham House in the 1970s. He has worked on a continuation of that book. And this is a book that will be published this year, hopefully, by Mythos Book. So now when we think of Lovecraft pastiche, of people trying to write like Lovecraft, in the voice of Lovecraft, in the style of Lovecraft, and basically ripping off all of Lovecraft's ideas, we think of August Derleth. And this is his book of pure Lovecraft pastiche, The Watchers Out of Time. The first Lovecraftian pastiche that he wrote. And he wrote these stories, and not only did he sign his own name to it, but as you can see, these are supposedly stories by August Derleth and H.P. Lovecraft. But Lovecraft had nothing to do with that book of fiction. He was dead when those stories were written. Derleth took ideas that he found in Lovecraft's commonplace book, and he wrote stories that he thought were in the narrative voice of Lovecraft. They were, in his mind, in Derleth's mind, they were a continuation of the work of H.P. Lovecraft. We may say, of course, pastiche is not only a literary form. There is a musical pastiche. And perhaps in modern times, the king of musical pastiche is Weird Al Yankovic. And thus, we may say of August Derleth that Derleth is the Weird Al of modern weird fiction. That's rather a delightful comparison. Seems almost blasphemous in some way, but it's true. Derleth is the Weird Al of Cthulhu Mythos fiction. So I've been thinking about all of this because, pardon me, my allergies are really acting up. There is a delightful book that I've just got, edited by Ellen Datlow, and it's called Lovecraft Unbound. This is a book of modern Lovecraftian fiction that cannot be termed Cthulhu Mythos. Now, I used to edit a magazine called Tales of Lovecraftian Horror with Robert M. Price that he published. And I had an editorial rule in that magazine that there would be no blatant Cthulhu Mythos fiction, that the book would only contain tales of pure Lovecraftian horror. I was not completely successful in that. Elements of the mythos did creep into the first three issues that I edited, and future issues edited by Bob Price. But with this book, Lovecraft Unbound, Ellen Datlow has succeeded where I did not. And it is a magnificent book of modern Lovecraftian fiction that pays homage to Lovecraft, but does not rip off his ideas or his prose style. It is a magnificent book, and I highly recommend it. So, I have much more to say about August Derleth, and I shall say that in part 2 of this vlog concerning Cthulhu Mythos.